Do I ever stop building kits? No, I do not. I love them. AMT's 1965 Pontiac GTO convertible, 2-in-1 stock or custom build. Check it out. You can make it into a sweet hardtop. You can do the convertible as it is on the box. Let's take a look at everything in styrene when you get yours. This is another kit like that Galaxy we just did and the Volkswagen, where there's not a gajillion parts, but it's enough to make a sharp looking GTO. So pull it open here. We've got wheel backs. We've got a cool steering wheel there with ribs on it. We got some body parts. We got the radiator mount, and we got a nice firewall with a significant amount of detailing. See the shadows in there on this tree. We've got the stock V8. You can see that short transmission because we're going to have that large chassis slab. Manifolds, heads. We got two different intakes here. We got a battery. We got a reservoir bottle, separate distributor. We got headers on this one and manifolds, so you can see where the 2-in-1 is coming in. You know, I know you customizers love when they have parts like that. We got some interesting seats. They got this cool crosshatch pattern going diagonal on the seats. You'll see it better when we get paint on them. We got what looks like hood hinges. We got a racing harness. We got that nice hood cut open. Don't have to do any surgery. We got our two tops on here. Check those out. Inside and out. So you can see your options for customizing there, for gluing things to the body. We've got our convertible boot. We've got a stock steering wheel. We've got the nice dashboard on there. Prominent detail too. You can actually feel those. They're not molded in, really soft. We got the chassis here, all one piece. These are very easy to paint, like I've shown before. Do a little dry brushing after you paint them, and it brings out the detail very nicely. Makes it look like a real world car. And you never have to worry about models sitting cattywampus when you have those steel axles going through there. We've got our interior pan, carpet detail, rear seat molded in, package shelf, simple GTO door panels. It's not like they were super decked out. Center console molded in, should be easy to detail with a silver pen. And our interior bucket on the other side. We got that nice drop top bodies. I don't get a chance to build a lot of convertibles, so I'm almost completely positive I'm not going to put the hard top on this one. Prominent molding for the GTO emblems, doors. We got our engine call out. Our trim is all nice and prominent on this. Nice thin molding on the windshield. That's why they've got it reinforced with this molding bar. And across the trunk, even the Pontiac logo is nice and prominent on there, so we shouldn't have many issues. Let's switch to the other side of the table. Look at that decal sheet. Remember the last GTO I built? Red, white, and blue pinstripes, depending on the color and how you want to do it. We got Hurst logos, a whole bunch of them for the wheels. We got trunk keyholes. We got four of them on there. We've got all kinds of Hurst call-out logos, GTO logos, spares, Gazoo. We got the engine call-outs for the 389. We got the badging on the side. We've got decals for our headlights, front lights. We've got three different dash options, three Pontiac logos, rear lights, a whole bunch of license plates. Nice to see those options. Keep doing that round two. Definitely keep up with the dash decals and some of the logos. Always do those, please. If I have any influence whatsoever, please do stuff like that for us easy model builders. We got transparent red taillights. We got our three pieces of two windshield glass and top glass in there. Remember, the headlights are molded in and we have decals. We've got one set of wheels. Check them out. Those should be the Hurst wheels that the decals are for, thrown in there on their own chrome tree. We got another chrome tree with some turbine wheels, some stock hubs. We got the headlights there. We got our rear bumper. All of this can be blackwashed super easy. We got dress-ups for the motor. Check that out. We got our grill inserts. I'll show you a tip on painting and detailing those to make your life go a lot easier. We got our hood scoop right there, all done for you. Don't have to cut anything out. Don't have to paint it separately. And what else is in the box? Could there be even more? There's four tires. Nope. 8 tires, round 2 throws them in. You get a gajillion tires with this kit. You've got really nice Goodyear polyglass GTs, completely hollow and flexible. Excellent tread pattern. Black wall on one side if you just wanted some wide vintage performance tires. You get 4 of those total, and you get the nice red lines, solid vinyl. Black on one side. I do not see a brand name imprinted on either of those. And we've got the nice tread pattern, the bias ply tread pattern. So you get a lot of value for your bucks in this kit with the decals and the new tires. I'm going to get to assembling, and we'll be right back. Absolute minimal assembly is needed to get this thing into paint. Pretty much it's just the engine is the major part that you put together. Now, I modified mine a little bit, did more of the custom engine in this one. I put the 3 2-barrel intake on it, and I put the headers on it. I just wanted it to be a little bit modified from stock, so that will look nice. Otherwise, you can put the completely stock 4-barrel intake on there and the exhaust manifolds and have it a 389 4-barrel sitting there with a regular air cleaner. But I like that 6-pack intake. Every car that comes with that available, I stick it on there. Now, I did glue the rear wheels together because I want to repaint those custom Hurst wheels, and we'll get those all coated up and then re-chromed as one piece. But I did leave the stock hubcaps alone, or the stock wheels alone, for the front of the car because I want to do some things with it on the tree. Same as all the chrome parts here, the valve covers, the 3 air cleaners, the carburation, and the front bumper. I kind of want to do something special. I did cut the grill free. What I'll end up doing is spraying the entire grill black, and then I just have to do around the outside of the rim here of the grills with a chrome paint pen. Much easier than trying to get in there and paint just the centers black and then do the duller style trim around the outside. So that's how I've done it before, like on a Firebird build. You can check out that 77 Firebird build for MPC. We got our battery and reservoir tank on the same tree. We'll be able to get those painted. The dash and the steering wheel. Pick your theme for that dashboard based on the 3 different dashboard decals. Paint it up that way to correspond. Our chassis is just one big slab. We just got to get paint on it. The interior is the same thing, or the body. I did cut off that mount so that we wouldn't have to worry about any areas back there. And it's completely solid once it's out of a box. That's just on there for when it's molded. They can get that thin part in there on the runners, and so it reinforces it while it's in the box. We will put that on our body stand and get that painted. Same as the hood with its cutout. We got the interior, we gotta get that primed and painted up. Our seats on their own tree, so we can paint those easily and flip them around. These parts over here that I thought were hinges, these are actually the sides of the seats. The brackets for the seats, so the hinges for the seats, pretty much. But yeah, that's what it ended up being, so I will paint those separately on metallic tone. Since they're separate, I can glue them on there afterwards. We got our belt and pulley system. The alternator is chrome in this box, so we'll leave it alone, but we'll paint that black. Same with the upper radiator hose. We've got our convertible boot, if you're going to be having it with the top down. So we've got that on its own little tree. I nipped off the other one. We can just hang on to it with that one. Clip it off, and there's barely any repainting necessary. And then we've got our firewall and our radiator support. Now, since they're supposed to be black on this car, and they'll be going inside the body and mounting up where those large mounts are in the body, I can use super glue for those. We can go again, paint them separately. Then I don't have to glue them in place, reach up in here and get them painted. It'll be a lot easier to paint them on this little tree. And that's it. I mean, it's really quick to get this thing into paint. So we're going to do that right now, and I will see you over there.
Thank you.
I've said it many times before, and I'll say it again, weathering a model for me is way easier than getting factory perfect clean paint jobs, because you don't have to worry about any mistakes. Check out the body on that GTO coming over, got the faded blue, got the patina of the surface rust, got some bare metal showing through where it's rubbed through over the years from rock chips and hasn't flash rusted yet. We got that nice hood on top of that body with all of its detail and patina. Faded paint, it all starts to work in eventually. Got the pitted chrome around the scoop, and then black wash that, and that thing looks nice and tight up there on top of the car. We've got that convertible boot. Now, this isn't all torn up yet or anything. It hasn't gotten that bad yet, but it is pretty faded and pretty dirty, but we'll take that off. We'll be gluing that on later, and then we can look at the body with just, for me, the right amount of rust all the way around. We got our grills in, got them dusted and dirtied up and highlighted on there. We've got a little bit rust on other sides. Remember, the rust doesn't always match on cars all the way around. You're not going to have the exact same kind of rust on one side that you will. Just in general areas, the fenders and stuff tend to rust somewhat similar, but there's always a tire that throws up a little more dirt and grime to rot those bodies out. And then glued in the firewall and the radiator surround after we pushed in the grill so I could get them in, and those are looking lovely. Got our glass in and everything. Might want to dust that up a little bit later. I'm not sure. I'll make a decision on that. But got that all in there looking great and glued in place. We got the interior buttoned up. I dusted up the inside with tile grout. I forgot for a second what I used. Just puffed it in there. And then I'll be sprinkling those leaves in once I get it all together. I don't want to do it now because when I put it in here and if I have to flip over and make adjustments, I'll end up losing them all on the table. So those are waiting. But we've got the crackle effects. You can check it out on that dashboard especially. On the seats, we got those white seats all cracked and weather torn from the sun. The top is completely gone. All he has is that boot that he found in the garage to put on the back to cover up that ruined top. He lives in a pretty warm climate, but still, he doesn't have a top on his car. Now, the engine I have not dirtied up yet too much. I want to wait till it's actually in the engine bay in the car. But you can see I've got rusted headers on there. We've got patina on all the metal parts. So it is somewhat dirtied up at this point. We'll just have to finish dirtying it up later when we drop it in the car. We'll use the same dry brushing and sprinkling of washes on there. The chassis, don't forget to dirty up underneath where the fenders are. And underneath, you see once that paint dries, stippled on some rust on the exhaust just by taking a paintbrush with more of the rust-colored paint and tapping it on it all the way around. We've got a nice amount of surface rust and crust and dirt colors and bare metal from being windswept and sand blown and all that stuff. So that looks pretty cool underneath with that shade of blue hiding in separate areas like it's been repainted a few times. And who knows what's happened to this car over its days, but I like beating them up a little bit. Check it out when you use a little bit of those rust colors. Over the rust we already did, you really get pitted chrome that needs some treatment on there. I made sure to keep the headlights somewhat silver. The glass bulbs in these headlights and everything would not fade like plastic lenses do now, and they certainly wouldn't rust, and they would protect the chrome behind them, so we'll make them stand out a lot more than bumpers that have been exposed to all the rust and crust. The wheel and tire package that I've decided on, we've got some bigger meats off the back with some fancier wheels that he bought back in the day. They're not as dirty and dusty as the front wheels. We got a black wall on one front wheel. We got one of the red stripes still left over on the other front wheel. And we got those wheels pitted pretty nicely. So real easy to do all this, as you saw in that longer section of how I do things. I'm just going to push everything together at this point, put a little wear and tear on that engine and transmission with some brown and black washes once it's under the hood, and we will be back for that final. I sure get a kick out of beating these kits up because it's fun and it's easy and it's a fun skill to do, especially if you're a beginner modeler. My opinion is weathering something up is easier than getting that beautiful factory finish, that perfect gloss and striping and everything. So if you're getting back into models, you're starting with models, grab a kit like this, super easy to get into, a two-in-one. You can do a hard top, a drop top. You could do it with the top down like I've got it. You can build it stock. You could build it custom with the engine details and all that, and yet still be pretty easy to put together and give weathering a shot and find out how easy it is and low stress. There's never stress when you build a weathered model because everything you do, every mistake you make, you just say it's part of the storyline. You know, this thing's been parked under some trees all summer. The guy's trying to sell it. He pushed it out of the barn. He's got a newer battery under the hood. I didn't weather the battery at all. I wanted to leave that kind of newer just so he could start it up, drive it to the end of the lot, and try to park it out there and sell it underneath the tree. So it's all full of leaves, and he's like, so what? It's a 65 GTO. You buy it, you're going to restore it. You're going to have to replace some body panels and stuff, but she's got that Tri-Power 389 under the hood. You definitely get the hold of this car and have something nice. Got a set of Hurst wheels on the back, stock wheels on the front. Don't forget, in this kit, you will, of course, get all the stuff we went over in the beginning. You get all the, you get a full set of red lines with black walls on the other side. You get a full set of polyglass tires. You got a full set of turbine wheels that I didn't use. You get a full set of the Hurst wheels. And you get an entire full set of the stock wheels, three sets of wheels. You get all these extra details for detailing any GTO and those three different sets of pinstripes. You got racing harnesses, you got extra tops, you got all kinds of parts in there. Lots of stuff in the box and those two-in-ones that you can save and use later. And this is how I always wanted to make a convertible. Convertibles are usually so nice, and I'm like, this time I gotta beat this one up and have a little fun, and I really enjoyed it. So I will put links in the description to get this on order. It's not quite out yet as of the published date of this video. This should be coming out on July 4th, so happy birthday, America. Everyone get out and have fun after you watch my video today, and we will see you at the next review.